నమస్కారం అండి, రాణి సదాశివమూర్తి గారు. లైక్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఇతిహాసాస్? ఎనీ వన్ కెన్ సే దట్ ఈస్ హౌ మెనీ ఇతిహాసాస్ వీ హ్యావ్? వాట్ ఆర్ దోస్? కెన్ ఎనీ వన్ రేజ్ ద హ్యాండ్ అండ్ ఓకే, శ్రియా ప్లీజ్ గో అహెడ్.
Two itihasas and it's Ramayana and Mahabharata.
Very good. Yeah, Abhidhamma also is.
There are three.
Okay, go ahead.
Ramayana, Mahabharata.
What is that?
Bhagavatam.
Okay. Okay. Bhagavatam is a Puran. We'll, anyway, Rani Sadasivamurthy garu will explain it why it is not itihasa part.
It takes me immense pleasure to introduce Rani Sadasivamurthy garu once again to all of you. I'm pretty sure we all were spellbound when he spoke about rishis and rishi paramparas and various rishis. Now he has come back for another session to talk about itihasas. So just a thing, Rani garu, not only kids are there, even adults are there in the call. You know, the parents of the kids are also there. Like, I don't have any kid, but I'm still in the call. We all really liked the way how you presented you know, those hard topics so lucidly to like people of all ages. So I'm just like waiting to hear from you once again on the topic of itihasas. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Rani Sadasivamurthy garu, please take over and then start, sir.
Kalyanim tamaniya kalpalatikam kameshwara ahladinim kadyarnam kamalalayendra vinutam kampatati vasinim kasturi tilakam katakshalaharim శ్రీకామకోటిప్రదాం కామాక్షీం గురురూపిణీం హృది భజే శ్రీకామకోట్యుజ్వలాం శ్రుతిస్మృతిపురాణానామాలయం కరుణాలయం నమామి భగవత్పాదశంకరం లోకశంకరం అపార కరుణా సింధుం జ్ఞానదం శాంతరూపిణం శ్రీ చంద్రశేఖర గురుం ప్రణమామి ముదాన్వహం. కామకోటి పీఠేశ్వరం కామాక్షి ప్రథమ కింకరం శ్రీ చంద్రశేఖరేంద్ర శిష్యం శంకరార్యం శివంకరం మహాదేవానందనందనం శ్రీ జయేంద్ర సరస్వతీం సర్వదేవమయాత్మకం వందే శ్రీ జగద్గురుం. దివిజ గంగా స్నాన ఫలదం తప పాద దర్శనం బుధజన కామధేను భక్తకోటి కల్పద్రుమం దీన జనార్థ చింతామణిం సాధుజన హృదయ మందారం సదా చింతయామి సద్గురు చరణారవిందం.
రోట్ రామాయణ
వాల్మీకి.
వాల్మీకి.
వెరీ గుడ్. సో
వాల్మీకి
కంటిన్యూ ద సెక్షన్ ప్లీజ్.
యే నైనం చిందంతి శస్త్రాణి నైనం దహతి పావకః న చైనం క్లేదయంత్యాపః దశోషయతి మారుతః పశ్యత్ స్థితాన్ పార్థః పితృన్నత పితామహాన్ ఆచార్యాన్ మాతులాన్ భ్రాత్రీన్ పుత్రాన్ పౌత్రాన్ సఖీం స్థతా
తం భుక్త్వా స్వర్గలోకం విశాలం క్షేణే పుణ్యే మర్త్యలోకం విశంతి ఏవం త్రయీ ధర్మమను ప్రపన్నాః గతాగతం కామ కామా లభంతే.
అగైన్
త్రైవిద్యా మాం సోమపాః పూత పాపాః యజ్ఞ ఋష్ట్వా స్వర్గతిం ప్రార్థయంతే తే పుణ్యమాసాద్య సురేంద్రలోకం అశ్నంతి దివ్యాన్ దివి దేవ భోగాన్.
तानि च पश्यामि विपरीतानि केशव तमश्चैवोनुपश्यामि वासांसि जीर्णानि यथा विहाय सर्वाणि गृह्णाति नरोपराणि तथा च जीर्णानि विहाय जीर्णानि संजाति नवानि नेहि
ओके ओके
अंतराय तिमिरोपशान्तये शान्तपावनमचिन्त्य वैभवं तं नरं वपुषि कुञ्जरं मुखे मन्महे किमपि तुन्दिलं महा ओं श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः ओं श्री मात्रे नमः ओं श्री महागणाधिपतये नमः रेस्पेक्टेड एल्डरली मेंबर्स प्रणाम्स टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड my humble pranams to the holy feet of Vijayendra Saraswati Swami Varu and also my pranams to all the elders whoever have gathered here and as per today's schedule I am asked to speak something about Ramayana and tomorrow I have to introduce about Mahabharata in the meanwhile I would like to give a brief introduction to Puranas also, though it was a content dealt with by the earlier scholars. I would like to bring the contextual relation of Puranas along with the Itihasas. So, actually, in our tradition, Ashtadasya Puranani. रामस्य चरितं महत् कार्ष्णो वेदः पञ्चमश्च यं महाभारतं विदुः जयेति नाम्ना यत् नाम्ना द्वेतांस्तु प्रवदन्ति मनीषिणः एक्चुअली वेरी ऑफ्टन वी मेट हैव हर्ड वन वर्ड दैट इज जया जया इज द नेम ऑफ विच टेक्स्ट
महाभारत
Excellent. But there are some more texts which are known by the word Jaya according to our tradition. But popularly Mahabharata is known as Jaya. It is sure and it is popular also. At the same time, in our ancient system, those people used to call the other texts also Jaya. What are they? He is enlisting here. Ashtadasya Puranani Ramasya Charitam Mahato. Ashtadasya Puranani, all the 18 Puranas, and then Ramasya Charitam. What is Ramasya Charitam? That is Ramayana. And Karshno Veda Panchamascha Krishna Veda, that is Mahabharata. All these texts, 18 Puranas, Ramayana, and Mahabharata, all these texts together were called Jaya. Jaye Eti Namanat Veta Amstu Pravadanti Manishinaha. So, in this manner, those people used to call Ramayana and 18 Puranas also with the name Jaya, as they used to call this Mahabharata. That we have to remember. So, Puranas is a class of literature. And then, Ramayana and Mahabharata belongs to another class of literature according to our convention. The interesting thing is to know about the difference between Puranas and the Itihasas. Both are the chronicles of our ancient Indian history, undoubtedly. They are not mythological stories. Yes, we are studying them in our textbooks. So they are not mythological stories. They were our ancient records of our ancient Indian history. Our history didn't begin with our Kali Yuga. Our history began with Dwapara, Krita, Treta, Krita, and even before that, there were many other ages. Through several ages, we have been coming to this particular thinking. That's why here in the Puranas, what are the historical content? and what is the historical content we can get, and what is the geographical content we have. These two things are very important for us. Even to know about the link between Puranas and Ramayana, Puranas and Mahabharata. Actually, they are all having interlinked connections. That's why when we want to think about Ramayana and Mahabharata, necessarily we have to go through Puranas also. So these Puranas, when we say that they are records of history, three aspects are very much essential. What are they? First one is historicity is essential. Then the second one is chronology is necessary, and geography. Which regions were ruled by which kings, that also should be known. For this sake, we will pay some attention here. Names of the, in this presentation, we are going to deal with some dynasties. Names of the dynasties which are available in the Puranas are going to be explained, that is first one. And after that, some stories of the kings, their kingdoms and their geographical boundaries also are available in the Puranas. But of course, we are not going to touch the stories of the kings, but we will be giving the names of the kingdoms, important kingdoms, and then time span during which they ruled also is available. We will be speaking about our time scale of ancient Indian systems, and then the races and tribes of different regions are also available. Interesting thing is this, the Puranas, they didn't actually, many people say that Puranas and Itihasas record only the histories of the royal people, only the histories of the kings and so on. But it was not like that. Hundreds and hundreds of races and tribes were also given a lot of information about. That's why if we look into the Puranas, we can get the information of races and tribes of different regions are also available. Then a note on Jambudvipa, Bharatavarsha, Bharatakanda, all this. Because in Sankalpa, in Sanyavandana or in Puja or anywhere, when we have to speak about region in which we are, we begin with Jambudvipa. Why should we begin with Jambudvipa? There is a reason. That also is going to be explained to you. And Jambudvipa, in the Jambudvipa again, Bharatavarsha, and in the Bharatavarsha, Bharatakanda. Why these three are the particular regions about which we have to mention in our daily rituals, that is given here. And after that, in our ancient times, Panchasat, Shatpanchasat Desha, 56 Deshas were very often spoken of. What are those 56 countries or regions? So that also will be given. And our India, our Bharat was rich in river systems. So region-wise rivers and riverside Janapadas also was given here. So in this manner, let us try to know about all these things in our present PPT. So through this, what we like to know is Puranas have the accounts of the kings ruled our country and also the world. There is a time scale also specified. All these are explained, so we need not read them again here. And ancient Indian time scale, this is. Actually, when we say ancient Indian time scale, people have an objection about our time scale. People say that our Indian time scale is cyclic and their time scale is linear, they say. Why do they call cyclic? Because they got confused with the names Kritayuga, Tretayuga, Dwaparayuga and Kaliyuga. Largest fractions of time, these are. When this kind of largest fractions of time are spoken of, they say after Kaliyuga, again Kritayuga comes, that is why this is cyclic, they say. It is their false opinion, because if we say that after Kritayuga, after Kaliyuga, again if Kritayuga comes, if it is their claim, we can say after December, which month comes? January. within an year itself they have that cyclic calculation. January, February, March, April, and so on we count till December, and after December again we come to January. So even those people also do have that kind of cyclic process. Even in a week we have, after Saturday we begin with again Sunday. So like this, everywhere cyclic counting is required, and linear counting also is there. What is the linear nature of our time? That we will be knowing now. Here, see Pauranic time scale, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3. In three phases, we will be learning. In the first one is the lowest time unit which we can take into consideration is just a time required to wink for one time. That is known as Nimesha. 24 Nimeshas make one Chanam. 24 Chanams make one Vighatika. And 60 Vighatikas make one Ghatika. 60 Ghatikas make one day. 7 days make one week. 15 days make one Paksha or fortnight. 2 fortnights or 2 Pakshas make one Masa or month. 6 months or 6 Masas make one Ayanam. 2 Ayanams, Uttarayanam and Dakshinayanam, or 12 months is one human year. This is we have to remember. And phase 2. Now let us come to the phase 2. Up to human year, we have taken into consideration here. So with this human year, taking this human year as our basic unit, we will go to the second phase. Here, let us begin with Kali Yuga. 4,32,000 human years make one Kali Yuga. 8,64,000 human years make Dwapara Yuga. This is double to Kali Yuga's length. And 12,96,000 human years is one Treta Yuga. That is triple to Kali Yuga. And 70,28,000 human years is one Kruta Yuga. It is 4 times to Kali Yuga. This is. So total, if we total these 4 Yugas, this is known as Chatur Yuga or one Mahayuga. So the length of this Mahayuga is 43,20,000 human years. This is the sum of 4 Yugas. So this Mahayuga is required. Next we go to the third phase. The time calculations of this phase are all useful to assess the events with the interference of divine elements in the history of universe. So Puranas all deal with the third phase of time scale. That is why when we have to understand Puranas, we need some patience, and we should not try to measure them in our human year calculation, but in the Brahma year calculation, we have to count them. So here, 1000 Mahayugas is one Kalpa, one day time of Brahma. So earlier we have spoken of one Mahayuga. What is one Mahayuga? That is 43,20,000 years. That is one Mahayuga. Such Mahayugas, if 1000, that is equal to one Kalpa. So that is 432 crores of years. That is one Kalpa or one daytime of Brahma. The same is the length of Brahma's night. Another 432 crores of years. So this is one Ahoratram. The day and night of Brahma is known as one Ahoratram. So one Ahoratram for Brahma is 864 crores of human years. So 864 crores into 360. That is Brahma's year. This kind of Brahma's years, 100, make this number of human years is 100 years lifespan of Brahma. Here we have 15 digits. That's why quadruplets, these are called. So 31,104 quadruplets make one Brahma's lifetime. The total span of Brahma has two halves, one Parartha and first Parartha and Dvitiya Parartha. So first Parartha makes 50 years of Brahma's age, Dvitiya Parartha makes the latter half. just Brahma entered into the Dvitiya Pararta at this time. So during this, the present kalpa history is known as Itihasa. And the past kalpa diary is Purana. That is the difference. Here, in the second Pararta, while Brahma is spending his time, and for each kalpa, there was one history, record of history. That record is known as Purana. And the record of present kalpa is known as Itihasa. These two Itihasas belong to the present kalpa only. But there are differences in Mahayugas. Ramayana took place in the 24th Mahayuga, whereas Mahabharata took place in the 28th Mahayuga, in which we are. So all this belong to Svetavaraha Kalpa. So Svetavaraha Kalpa is the present day of Brahma. During his day, we have references to Ramayana and Mahabharata. Ramayana belongs to 24th Mahayuga. So 24th Mahayuga is 1,86,000 years, 86 lakhs of years back. So it took place, Ramayana. And ever since it has been preserved. So now let us know certain descendants of Vaivasvata Manu and Surya Vamsa. Surya Vamsa is solar rays from which many great kings took birth and they ruled the Mahabhumi. What is Mahabhumi? We will be learning about in the Jambudvipa. So the descendants of Vaivasvata Manu and Surya Vamsa in the Satya Yuga and Treta Yuga we will be learning. So here Ikshvaku Vamsa. Ikshvaku was one of the greatest kings of Surya Vamsa. So in his name there is one race. Ikshvaku Putra Vamsa. It is another race. And Raghu Vamsa, Kusha Vamsa, Kushadvaja Vamsa, Danda Vamsa, Parusha Vamsa, Kavi Vamsa, Dishta Vamsa, Drishta Vamsa, Narishyanta Vamsa, Nabhaga Vamsa, Nriga Vamsa, Prashadvara Vamsa, Pramsu Vamsa, Sharyati Vamsa, and Sudyumna Vamsa. These are the Vamsas belonging to Surya Vamsa. Why do they call each king's life and each king's kingdom as one Vamsa? Because there are certain descendants separated from Surya Vamsa following Ikshvaku's line. That's why they belong to Ikshvaku Vamsa. And similarly, the rest of the dynasties also. Similarly, the dynasties of Treta and Dwapara Yugas here, the descendants of Chandravamsa. Chandravamsa people can be seen in the Dwapara and at the end quarter of Treta, and from the beginning till the end of Dwapara, we have Chandravamsa people. Angavamsa, Anuvamsa, Anenasvamsa, Amavasuvamsa, Chatravamsa, Chatravardhavamsa, Turvavsuvamsa, Druhyuvamsa, Nahushavamsa, and Yaduvamsa. These were the people of various dynasties. So various races of Yaduvamsa again, Kakura or Andhakavamsa, Kratavamsa, Krostuvamsa, Devavritavamsa, Nignavamsa, and Bhajamanavamsa, Mahabhojavamsa, Vrishnivamsa, Prishnivamsa, Shinivamsa, and Haihayavamsa, and Rajivamsa. So these are. And after that, the other major Vamsas other than Chandra Vamsa. These Vamsas do not belong either to Surya Vamsa or to Chandra Vamsa, but these are independent Vamsas mentioned in the Puranas. So Puranas have given us information about these Vamsas also. That is to be underlined by us. Purvamsa, Garga Vamsa, Dvijamedha Vamsa, Naravamsa, Nilavamsa, Puru Janamejaya Vamsa, and Brihakshatra Vamsa, Brihadisha Vamsa, and Mahaviri Vamsa, Sudhana Vamsa, and Shautra Vamsa. These are the Vamsas other than Chandra Vamsa and Surya Vamsa. After this, in the dynasty of ಕಲಿಯುಗ ಪೌರವ ವಂಶ, ಇಕ್ಷ್ವಾಕು ವಂಶ, ಬೃಹದ್ರಥ ವಂಶ, ಪ್ರದ್ಯೋತ ವಂಶ, ಶಿಶುನಾಗ ವಂಶ, ನಂದವಂಶ, ಮೌರ್ಯ ವಂಶ, ಶುಂಗ ವಂಶ, ಕಣ್ವ ವಂಶ, ಆಂಧ್ರ ವಂಶ, ಪಾರಮಾರ ವಂಶ, ಚಾಫಣಿ ವಂಶ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಗ್ನಿ ವಂಶ, ಶಾಲಿವಾಹನ ವಂಶ, ಭೋಜ ವಂಶ, ತೋಮಾರ ವಂಶ, ಶುಕ್ಲ ವಂಶ, ಪಣಿಹಾರ ವಂಶ, ವಿದೇಶ ರಾಜವಂಶ. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ವಂಶಸ್, ಡಿನಾಸ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ 18 ಪುರಾಣಸ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ 18 ಪುರಾಣಸ್? ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ನೋ, ಎರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಭಾಗವತ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇತಿಹಾಸಸ್. ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಭಾಗವತ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಅಮಾಂಗ್ ದಿ 18 ಮಹಾಪುರಾಣಸ್. ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪುರಾಣಸ್, ಯೂಸ್ವಲಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಸೇ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಪುರಾಣಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಟೋಟಲಿ? ಅದ್ಭುತಂ ಅದ್ಭುತಂ, ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಪುರಾಣಾನಿ. ಸೊ ದೇಸ್ ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಮಹಾಪುರಾಣಾನಿ, ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಉಪಪುರಾಣಾನಿ, ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಔಪಪುರಾಣಾನಿ, ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಉಪ ಉಪಪುರಾಣಾನಿ. ಆಹತ್ಯ ಕತಿ ಪುರಾಣಾನಿ? ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಮಹಾಪುರಾಣಾನಿ, ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಉಪಪುರಾಣಾನಿ, ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಔಪಪುರಾಣಾನಿ, ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಉಪ ಉಪಪುರಾಣಾನಿ. ಆಹತ್ಯ ಕತಿ ಪುರಾಣಾನಿ? ಪಶ್ಯಂತು ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಪುರಾಣಾನಿ ಮಹಾಪುರಾಣಾನಿ, ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಉಪಪುರಾಣಾನಿ. ಆಹತ್ಯ ಕತಿ ಭವತಿ, ಕಿಯತ್ ಭವತಿ? ಷಟ್ರಿಂಶತ್. ಅನಂತರಂ ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಔಪಪುರಾಣಾನಿ ಯದಿ ಯೋಜಯಾಮಃ ಕಿಯತ್ ಭವತಿ?
ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಅಲ್ಪಪುರಾಣಾನಿ, ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಉಪಪುರಾಣಾನಿ,
ಚತುಷ್ಪದ್ಯಾಸತ್ ಭವತಿ. ತೇಷಾಂ ಪುನಃ ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ ಯೋಜಯಂತು, ತದಾನಿಂ ಕಿಂ ಭವತಿ? ಉಪೋಪುರಾಣಾನಿ ಚತುಷ್ಪಂಚಾಶತ್ ತತಃ ಅಷ್ಟಾದಶ.
ದ್ವಿಸಪ್ತತಿ.
ಹಾ ದ್ವಿಸಪ್ತತಿ, ಅದ್ಭುತ. ಅತಃ ದ್ವಿಸಪ್ತತಿ ಪುರಾಣಾನಿ ಸಂತಿ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ 72 ಪುರಾಣಸ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪುರಾಣಸ್ ಭಾಗವ 18 ಮಹಾಪುರಾಣಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್. ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ 18 ಪುರಾಣಸ್? ಯು ಮೈಟ್ ಹವ್ ಹರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ 3 days ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಶ್ಲೋಕ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಹವ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಬೈ ಹಾರ್ಟ್. ಪುರಾಣಾನಿ ಪೃಥಕ್ ವಿದುಃ.
ಮದ್ವಯಂ ಭದ್ವಯಂ ಚೈವ ಭ್ರತ್ರಯಂ ವಿದುಃಸ್ತಯಂ ಅನಾಪಲಿಂಗ ಗೋಸ್ತಾನಿ ಪುರಾಣಾನಿ ಪ್ರತಿಷ್ಠತೆ.
ಪುರಾಣಾನಿ ಪೃಥಕ್ ವಿದುಃ. This is the shloka according to this madvayam, beginning with ma, two puranas, matsya purana, markandeya purana, bhadvayam, bhagavata purana and bhavishyat purana. Here we have the krishna bhagavata. So when we say krishna bhagavata is one among these 18 puranas, it cannot be a itihasa. It is a separate one. That is why madvayam bhadvayam cha bhagavatam bhavishya purana. ಬ್ರತ್ರಯಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಪುರಾಣಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಂಡ ಪುರಾಣಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮವೈವರ್ತ ಪುರಾಣಂ ಅಂಡ್ ವಚತುಷ್ಟಯಂ ವರಾಹ ಪುರಾಣಂ ವಾಯುಪುರಾಣಂ ವಾಮನ ಪುರಾಣಂ ವಿಷ್ಣು ಪುರಾಣಂ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಅನಾಪಲಿಂಗ ಕೂಸ್ಕಾನಿ ಆ ಅಗ್ನಿ ಪುರಾಣಂ ನಾ ನಾರದೇ ಪುರಾಣಂ ಪಾ ಪದ್ಮ ಪುರಾಣಂ ಲಿಂ ಲಿಂಗ ಪುರಾಣಂ ಗಾ ಗರುಡ ಪುರಾಣಂ ಕೂ ಕೂರ್ಮ ಪುರಾಣಂ ಸ್ಕ ಸ್ಕಂದ ಪುರಾಣ ಸೊ 18 ಪುರಾಣಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಮಾಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ 18 ಪುರಾಣಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಭಾಗವತ ಪುರಾಣ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೊ ಭಾಗವತ ಪುರಾಣ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ 18 ಪುರಾಣಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಪುರಾಪಿ ನವಮಿವ ಭಾತಿ ಇತಿ ಪುರಾಣ ದೋ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೀಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಎವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಎವರ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಟು ಅಸ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಪುರಾಣ ಅಂಡ್ ಇತಿಹಾಸ it had happened so it was so that's why it is itihasa itihasa So this is the difference between Itihasa and Purana. So now geographical regions, let us know what is geographical classification around us. So in this universe, Dvipas are several thousands in number. Dvipa, according to the definition given in the Puranas, Ekena Samudrena Valetaha Ekaha Dvipaha, whichever is encircled by one ocean, not by sea or not by a canal, not by any river, but when it is encircled by one ocean, it is called one Dvipa. Around the entire human planet, what is the human planet? Bhugola. So around this Bhugola, we have how many oceans? How many oceans are there around this Bhugola?
Sapta samudraha
na santi. Eka eva samudraha asti. Lavana samudraha asti. Lavana samudrena parivrutaha ayam pradeshaha. समस्त मानव देशः भूगोल प्रदेशः अतः एक एव समुद्रः अस्ति अवशिष्ट समुद्राः कुत्र सन्ति इति अहं वदिष्यामि आई विल टेल अबाउट द रेस्ट ऑफ द समुद्रास व्हिच आर दे एंड वेयर दे डू एग्जिस्ट ऑल दिस थिंग्स सो आवर एंटायर ग्लोब इज एनसर्कल्ड बाय वन ओशन दैट इज साल्ट ओशन दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव सेवन द्वीपास फ्रॉम आवर human planet to Dhruva Mandala, but not most of the people eagerly try to show all these seven dvipas, major dvipas, in the human earth itself. But according to Puranas, it is not like that. Up to Dhruva Nakshatra, all these, the seven, Jambu, Laksha, Shalmali, Kusha, Krauncha, Shaka, and Pushkara. These are the names of the seven major dvipas. So the span of every higher dvipa is double to the span of the lower dvipa. Jambu dvipa is the lowest, where all of us do live. This is human planet, this is globe on which we stay. So from this, above to Jambu dvipa, there was the Vayuskandha, that is wind circle around each dvipa is called samudra according to our Surya Siddhanta and other texts. That's why the other samudras are Kshira Samudra, Ikshu Samudra, Sura Samudra, Dadi Samudra. All such samudras were not there. They are all Sapta Vayuskandhas, the atmospheric region of each of the planet is known as one samudra. So Jambu dvipa, above to that Plakshadvipa is there, above to that Shalmali Dvipa is there, above to that Kushadvipa is there, above to that Krauncha is there, above to that Shakadvipa is there, above to Shakadvipa, the end one is Pushkaradvipa. Above the Pushkaradvipa, we have this Dhruva Nakshatra. Above this Dhruva Nakshatra, we have the Sumeru Parvatas. The Sumer Parvata's beginning is in our earth, human planet, and end is beyond Dhruva Nakshatra. That's why there Sumeru Sringa, the top peaks of Sumeru, four peaks are there. And what are those four peaks? In the middle peak, Rajarajeshwari, Lalita Ambika, she dwells. And in the lower three peaks, Brahma, Vishnu and Maheshwara, they stay. This is the description according to our Puranas. So this is first one, Jambu Dvipa. What is Jambu Dvipa? Human planet. So let us confirm that Jambu Dvipa is human planet, but not a part of our globe, human planet. It is not Jambu Dvipa. Entire human planet is Jambu Dvipa. This is one. And after that, in the Jambu Dvipa, we have the following description. Here is the description of Jambu Dvipa and its subdivisions. In Jambu Dvipa, there are seven Varshas. Varsha is name of a place. It is not rain. So here, the Jambu Dvipa's diameter is 1 lakh yojanas. One yojana is equal to 5 miles or 9.25 kilometers. And many countries and beautiful cities are to be found in it. It is full of siddhas and charanas and is adorned by mountains, full of ores, that is mines, etc. Different kinds of metals are available, different kinds of gems and precious stones are available. Herbal richness is there, rivers were there, and janapadas were there, like that. And besides this, it is beautifully embellished by various rivers following the mountains. There are seven ranges of mountains running from east to west, demarcating the seven varshas. Actually, the mountains, about mountains, we have to know something here. They are Shakha Parvatas, Sima Parvatas, Kula Parvatas, like that. There are different types of mountains. Shakha Parvatas means an extended branch of one big mountain that is known as Shakha Parvata. It seems to be aloof, but it is a part of a series of Parvatas that is known as Shakha Parvata. And Sima Parvata, which divides two countries or two regions, that is known as Sima Parvata. And Mala Parvata, Himalaya, and etc. And Kulaparvata, there are seven Kulaparvatas. We will be talking about it in course of time. So here in the Jambudvipa, the names of the Parvatas are Himalaya, and then Hemakota, then Nishadha Mountain, then Meru, then Nala Mountain, then Sweta Mountain, and then Sringi Mountain. These are the Satakumbha Mountain, this is also known. And wonderful informations are there about these mountains. And when we find some time, we can know about this. And after this, about the other informations. So Sweta, Hemakuta, Himavan, Sringavan, Rishabha, some major mountains of Jambudvipa. And with the same names, we have the Varshas also. Varsha means, as I was telling you, it is a name of a part of this one. The seven parts of Jambudvipa are like this. Here, the Bharata Varsha is there. And the seven Varshas are Bharata Varsha, Yamakuta Varsha, Harivarsha, Ilanavrata Varsha, Ramyaka Varsha, and Hiranyaka Varsha. Of these, the Bharata Varsha is Vaivasvata Manu came to be known as Bharata by his creation and protection of the people of Bharata. So because he protected all this, Bharanat Bharata Uchate, Vaivasvata Manu was the son of Vivaswan. Who is Vivaswan? Vivaswan is the son. So son is Vaivasvata. So that Manu was known as Bharata because of even Shakuntala's son also was Bharata. His birth was very later birth, but earliest birth was of Vaivasvata Manu. He was the first human being, Vaivasvata Manu is. So that Vaivasvata Manu ruled this country. That's why this Bharata Varsha is known by his name, and he was known as Bharata. Bharata, because he took care of the people. That's right. And after that, this Bharata Varsha has again nine divisions. Indra Dvipa, Kaseru Dvipa, Tamraparni Dvipa, Gavastimana Dvipa, Naga Dvipa, Saumya Dvipa, Gandharva Dvipa, Varuna Dvipa, and Bharata Khanda. These Dvipas are also known as Khandas. Indra Dvipa Khanda, Kaseru Khanda, Tamraparni Khanda, Gavastiman Khanda, like this. Last one is Bharata Khanda. So this Bharata Khanda is the place to which we belong. So this is surrounded on all sides by the ocean. And on the in the east side, we have the mountain Himalaya. So the whole of the Dvipa is 1,000 yojanas in extent from north to south. It is gradually broader from Kumari, Kanyakumari, to the mouth of the Ganga, where it has risen to a height of 10,000 yojanas in an oblique direction. The Kiratas and the Yavanas inhabited the east and the west of it. So on either sides of it, we have the Kiratas. The Kiratas are the China people. So the China region is known as Mahakirata Desha. That is one of the part of our geography. And Bharatakanda, here exist the ashramas in their due order, in which the fivefold desires of men are fulfilled. Nishkama Dharma also was done. All these things are there. So just introduce you about these differences, we are speaking of this. The seven mountains of the rain, Mahendra, Malaya, Sahya, Sakriman, and Rikshva, and Vindhya, and Pariyatra. The other names of these are Mahendra, Malaya, Sahyo, Devatatma, Himalaya, Jayo, Raivatko, Vindhya, Girish, Aravalistada. These are the seven Kulaparvatas. The description of Kulaparvata, according to our Purana, is like this. If it has some 10,000 feet height, and into the earth also, the length of it goes up to 10,000 feet depth. So that is Kulaparvata. So like this, Kulaparvata's the upper part, the extent of upper part is equal to the extent of the lower part, which intruded into the earth. So that is Kulaparvata. Such Kulaparvatas are seven: Mahendra, Malaya, Sahya, Himalaya, Rikshavan, Vindhya, Pariyatra, etc. So here, regarding rivers, we will have detailed this one. Rivers of this region, Pariyatra Mountain, the rivers of Pariyatra Mountain region. So these are the Mlechas and the Aryans decide their mingling with each other without distinction, and they drink the waters of many rivers such as the Ganga, Sindhu, Saraswati, Satluj, Chandrabhaga, Yamuna, Sarayu, Airavati, Vitasta, Devaki, Devika, Puhu, Gomati, the Dhautapada, Huda, Drishadvati, Kaushiki, Tritya, Nishchala, Gandaki, Yikshu, and Lauhita. These are all the rivers of the Himalayan range. Wonderfully, very interestingly, about every river there is a story. How that river came into existence, we have beautiful description, but we are not going into details now, or even when Puranas are available also, we don't try to know about that. That is our weakness. But here, for every river, there is a story. And now Pariyatra Mountain rivers, the Veda Smriti, Vetravati, Vrtaghini, Sindhu, etc. These are similarly for Rishavan Mountain, Mandakini, Dasharana, Chitrakuta, Tamasa, Pippali, Sieni, Chitrotpala, Vimala, Chanchala, like this. These are all the names of the rivers which are flowing on Rishavan Parvata. And Vindhya Mountains, Tapati, Tapi, Ayoshni, Nirvindhya, Kshipra, Rishabha, Vaitarini, Vishwamala, Kumudvati, Doya, Mahagauri, and Durgama, Shila, all these are the names of the rivers of this Vindhya Mountains. After this, Sahya, rivers of Sahya, Godavari, Bhimarathi, Krishnaveni, Banjula, Tungabhadra, Supayoga, and Vahya, and Kaveri. These belong to Sahya Mountain rivers. And Kirnamala, Tamraparani, Pushpaja, Utpalavati, these belong to Malayachala. And Shaktimantaparvata, there are certain rivers. In this manner, more than 5,000 rivers are there in our India, in our Bharat Desha, according to our Puranas. We must know about this. Names of the races of people of different regions of Bharatavarsha. This is, here we have one interesting and wonderful account. This was identified even by Varaha Mihira in his Brihat Savhita. As mentioned by Varaha Mihira, an entire Bharat Desha is compared to some Kurma. Kurma is tortoise. So what is the shape of tortoise? In the central part, it is just elevated. Hard cover is there over the back of the tortoise. That is an elevated one, and it is a higher one compared to the other parts of the tortoise, and which is in an elevated situation than the other ones. So the other parts slowly slope down, the four legs and the tail, all these are sloping down towards the earth. Similarly, entire India is compared to a tortoise, and they say Kurma Vibhaga. They say Kurma Vibhaga. So in the Kurma Vibhaga, the face of tortoise is towards north, the tail is towards the Kanyakumari, and the four legs are towards the other directions. In such a way, they have classified. And now the northern region, Angalikas, Anibhadras, Prantas, Avaganas, Abhiras, Aurasas, Kantakaras, Kampojas, like this, we have a grand list of the people of different races who reside in the northern region of our country. That is. And after that, so here we have the races related to southern region. Andhra, Alupa, Asmaka, Atavya, Udbhida, Rishika, Kalinga, Kavera, Kuntala, etc. Similarly, mountain races, those who dwell in the mountains. We know that seven major mountains are there. Some Shakha Parvatas are there. So some extensions of all these Parvatas. They're Parvata Pranta people who live in Parvatas. They are Karna Pravaranas, Kiratas, Puravas, Khasyas, Tanganas, Tomaras, Trigartas, Darvas, Niraharas, Malavas, Hamsavargas, Punas and Kuhukas. These were mountain range people and western people, Aparanta, Arbuda, Anartha like that. And in the eastern race, Angas, Antargiris, Angeyas, Gonadas, like this. These are all people of this people. That's why here we have to observe how carefully they mentioned about the races also, not merely about the kings, but different people, different kinds of people who lived there. They are also were mentioned. Here, Madhya Deshikas. So this Madhya Pradesha, which is tortoise back, like this, it is elevated part. On the elevated part, we have Andhakas, Avantas, Kashyas, Kiratas, Kuntayas, Kurupancharas, Kulyas, etc. And then Vindhyadeshiyas. The Vindhyaparvata is central part of the entire Bharata Desha. There we have Anupas, Avantyas, Utkalas, Uttamaras, Karushas, etc. So these types of races were mentioned. After that, 56 regions of Bharata Varsha. Anga, Vanga, Kalinga, Karnataka, Kerala, Kavarupa, Gauda, Vanavasa, Kutala, Kuntala, Kokan, Konkana, Magadha, Saurashtra, Malava, Lata, Bota, Varata, Chavara, Kukura, Kurvavati, like this. So these are 56 deshas, ending with Kamboja, Bhaka, Chola, and Huna, Kasi. Kasi is the last one. Anga is the beginning. In between, 56 regions are there in the Bharata Varsha. So these are all mentioned. So riverside cities, here they have mentioned. On their banks are situated the following Janapadas places: Panchala, Kuru, Salva, Jangala, Surasena, Bhadraka, Vashya, Mukha, Matsya, Kirata, Kulya, Kuntala, Kasi, Kosala, Avanti, Kalingam, Mukha, Andhaka. These are all the riverbank cities situated. These are also known as Janapadas situated in the Vanchadesha. Similarly, Northern Janapadas. Similarly, Dakshina Janapadas. After that, Western Janapadas. After that, Eastern Janapadas. After that, mountain ranges. Niraharas, all these people were mentioned. And Janapadas also are in the name of the people who lived in those regions. So, the modern names which can be identified also are given here. So Bahika is modern Balkha, and Sindhu, the country of upper Indus, Sakha, the country of the northwest frontier, Kaikeya, bordering in the Sindhu Desha, Abhira, south of Konkan, and western bank of the Tapti, is the lands of Abhiras and Vidya Hills, Anga near Bhagalpur, Vanga also called Samatala, eastern Bengal, Vidhiha, the country lying to the northeast of Magadha. Magadha is Bihar, Kerala, modern Malabar, the strip of land between Western Ghats and the sea north of the Kaveri, Chola, Tanjore, Pandya, Tirunelveli, and Vidarbha, and Berar, like this. All these are the, to some extent, we try to identify their modern names also. So, this much is available about our Puranas. So this is about the Puranas when we want to know about. This type of approach is necessary while studying the Puranas. As I was telling you, 72 Puranas are there. So this is just about geography, chronology, and also about the dynasties which ruled us during the past Mahayugas and during the past ages, Treta Yuga, Krita Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, and Kali Yuga. The names of the major dynasties are given. There is a lot more information about this because of many limitations. I limited myself. I confined myself to this much information only. And now the most important part is Ramayana. So when we have to speak about Ramayana, so there can be, it is just like Ramayana is a itihasa, basically. And Ramayana is a text of our, it is a holy text also. It is a text of our moral guide. And it is a wonderful text of our human behavior. There are many, many things in the Ramayana. So when we say when we want to know about Ramayana, from any aspect we can do. But out of this, so Ramayana, and first, Charitam Raghunathasya Shatakoti Previstaram Ekaikavaksharam Pumsam Mahapataka Nashanam. The holy element is there in it, and the extent of Ramayana also is given here. Charitam Raghunathasya. He belongs to the dynasty of Raghu, race of Raghu. He is a descendant of Raghu. Dilipa, Dilipa's son Raghu. And after that, there are many kings. And then we have Dasharatha. Dasharatha's son is Rama. So Rama is the descendant of Raghu. That's why he is known as Raghunatha, who belongs to Raghu, and Natha, because he is the king of the Ayodhya, and he is known as Raghunatha. Charitam Raghunathasya, it is the story of Raghunatha. Shatakoti Previstaram, it is extended to 100 crores of slokas. But in the modern times, it is available in how many slokas? So, do you know about Kanda division at least?
Yeah, seven Kandas.
No,
seven Kandas. Come on. What are the names of those seven Kandas?
Balakanda,
Uttarakanda.
Excellent. Well said. So, Balakanda is the first one, then Ayodhya Kanda, then Aranya Kanda, then Kishkindha Kanda, after that Sundara Kanda, after that Yuddha Kanda. Usually people close here with Yuddha Kanda, and after Yuddha Kanda, we have the Uttara Kanda. So, this is the scheme of the Ramayana. In this manner, he wrote. And here we have, if we include Uttarakhanda, we have nearly 26,500 shlokas. If we exclude Uttarakhanda, it is nearly 23,600 and some shlokas. That is why, because it is nearing 24, we call Ramayana as Chaturvimshati Sahasri. Chaturvimshati Sahasri is the another name of Ramayana. That means it has 24,000 shlokas in it, people say. But in fact, according to internal source of Ramayana, how many shlokas are there? Shatakoti Previstaram. It has 100 crore shlokas. Out of 100 crore shlokas, presently we have only 24,000 shlokas with us. That is, and Valmiki Giri Sambhuta Ramambhunidhi Sangata Srimad Ramayani Ganga Punati Bhuvanatrayam. This is the holy aspect of Ramayana again. Valmiki Giri Sambhuta, usually a river bonds, river gets birth where? From the top of a mountain. So here there is a mountain-like personality. That is the personality of Valmiki. It is not physical personality. He is such a great person. To say that, they told Valmiki Giri Sambhuta. So this Ramayana was born from Valmiki. Another beautiful thing is there. Vedas were learnt by our ancient people, in what manner? Have they written and read the Vedas?
No, it was through listening and repeating.
Listening and repeating. Listening, memorizing and repeating. This was the way of learning. So it was told as oral tradition. Shruti. Veda is known as Shruti because it is heard and learnt. That's why it is known as Shruti. Whereas even the steps of Vedas were followed by this Ramayana also. They also, the Ramayana also was not written by Valmiki. We must underline this. It was not written by Valmiki. But he expressed it. He instructed it to the two children of Rama. They heard it, they learnt it, they started singing in praise of Rama. And therefore many people learnt. Through ages, it got down to us. So that's why Ramayana was authored by Valmiki, but not in a book form. But as Veda was a Shruti, Ramayana also was Shruti. It was sung. It was produced by Valmiki. There was no record of writing it. We have to understand. So, Valmiki Giri Sambhuta Ramambhu Nidhi Sangata. It born from Valmiki and merged in the ocean-like qualities, virtues of Rama. That's why it became a wonderful river stream of perennial life. So ever in all the three times in past, during the time of Treta Yuga, it was there. And in Dwapara Yuga, it was there. And in Kali Yuga, it was there. Very interestingly, Krishna was in the cradle. He was a very little boy. When he was a little boy, Yashoda used to tell him the Dashavatara stories every day to Krishna. That is why one day she was explaining the story of Rama to him. So in the process of explaining him the story of Rama, she told, Ramo Nama Babhuva. So she was moving the cradle, and in the cradle, the Lord Sri Krishna, just in his infancy, he was there. He was a very little child and he was listening to the stories narrated by his mother, and she was telling, Ramo Nama Babhuva. There was a king named Rama, she told. This boy, this child was telling, so he was listening to her. That's why he said, Ramo nama babhuva, tadavarasite tihum. His wife's name is Sita, she told. He heard that also. Ramo nama babhuva, tadavarasite tihum. तौ पितुर्वाचा पंचवटीवने निवसतः सो बिकॉज ऑफ द वर्ड ऑफ हिज फादर गिवन टू हर स्टेप मदर रामा टुक ए डिसीजन टू गो टू फॉरेस्ट एंड ही वांटेड टू स्टे देयर फॉर सम इयर्स एज पर द वर्ड गिवन बाय हिज फादर अकॉर्डिंगली ही एंड हिज वाइफ अलोंग विद लक्ष्मण दे केम टू पंचवटी फॉरेस्ट And there they spent a lot of their time in the Panchavati. We will be learning about it. So, Tau pitur vacha panchavati vani nivasataha tamahar tatrapi He heard to his mother's voice and he said, So, tamahar dravanaha That Sita was abducted by Ravana there in the Panchavati region, she told. To that part of the story, Krishna was calmly listening. And slowly, there was a transformation in the Balakrishna. Now he is assuming the Rama Bhava in him. Now I am Rama. My wife is abducted by Ravana. Hence, the reaction of Krishna is like this. कृष्णे नेति पुरातनीं निज कथां आकर्ण्य मात्रेरितां सौमित्रे क्वधनुर धनुर धनुरिति प्रतागिरः पान्तु वः सो कृष्णे नेति पुरातनीं निज कथां इन दिस मैनर हैविंग हर्ड अबाउट हिज ओन स्टोरी नरेटेड बाय हिज मदर द स्टोरी ऑफ ओल्डन डेज ओल्डन टाइम्स There was a Yuga gap. Krishna belongs to Dwapara Yuga. And this Rama belongs to not the immediate Treta Yuga, but 24th Mahayuga's Antar Yuga, that is. So it was his old and great olden story. So Krishna Neti Puratani Nizakadham Akarnyam Matre Ritam What was narrated by his mother, he heard that story. Immediately, he woke up from the cradle. He held the golden chain of that cradle. And Saumitri, Saumitri means Sumitra Nandana, the son of Sumitra. Who is Sumitra Nandana? Who is Sumitra Nandana? Lakshmana.
Lakshmana! Saumitra!
Saumitra is Lakshmana. Saumitre, he Lakshmana, Padhanur Dhanur Dhanuriti. Where is my bow? Like that he was telling. Why? To kill Ravana again. So that was the spirit of the boy. So even Krishna got inspiration from the story of Rama. So even Yashoda narrated the story of Rama. So this kind of evidences are there. सौमित्रे क्वधनुर्धनुर्धनुरिति प्रोक्तागिरः पान्तु वः द वर्ड्स ऑफ कृष्णा हु आस्क्ड सौमित्र आर लक्ष्मण टू गिव हिम हिज वो दोज वर्ड्स मे प्रोटेक्ट यू ऑल दिस इज द बेनेडिक्ट स्टैंजा सो दिस काइंड ऑफ ग्रेटनेस इज देयर इन द रामायण एंड हियर द इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग इज रामस्य अयनम रामायणम Ayana means the path, marga, the way which was laid down by Rama, that is followable to all of us. That's why Ramayanam, Ramasya Ayanam Ramayanam, who is Rama? He is the human manifestation of Dharma. What is Dharma? Our own duty. How many duties we do have? as a son, as a husband when after marriage, and as a father of children, as a friend of friends, as a dutiful servant in a service, and as a citizen in a country, as a social being, and as a being in the universe. All these are the responsibilities assigned to every human being. But while we are in studies, as a student, if we are teaching as a teacher, the professional responsibilities, as a guru, our responsibilities, all these were there. So actually, a drama, if we take, in a drama, how many characters can be played by a single actor? Only one. But here, in the drama of life, life also is equal to a drama. And in a drama of life, we have to play how many characters? A friend's character, a son's character, a father's character, a sishya's character, a guru's character, a social being's character, and a ruler's character. Like this, number of characters we have. As an enemy, as a leader, number of characters are to be played. If we take the life of Rama, he did justice to every aspect of his life. That is why Ramaha Vigrahavan Dharmaha, they called. Rama is the human manifestation. He didn't forget homework. I should do it. Have I completed my homework or not? Just let me wink for a while. After that, tomorrow I can do my homework. I have some leisure tomorrow. If we say that is wrong, Shvakarya Madhya Kurivita. Rama says, read Ramayana. He can become your best friend. Rama becomes your best friend if you read Ramayana. Ramayana, Mahabharata, Puranas, Vedas, all these are not just lifeless books. But these are guiding persons with us who have been guiding our country through several ages. So Rama will be with us. What does he say? Swakarya Madhya Kurveta. Don't do today's work tomorrow, but try to do tomorrow's work also even today. That is the first advice. Adhyakaryam tu sampratam. Today's work, when should we do? Now itself. Palake pralayo bhavi. On your forehead, there may be many events written. Unwanted events may take place. See, just why we wanted to sit and start Ramayana in the beginning. When we wanted to start Ramayana, suddenly a fall of thunderbolt was there in our region. As a result, the power was off. That is why we had to wait for some time. After waiting for some time, we prayed to God. We prayed to all our divine people. We got electricity. We got back the power. And as a result, we all are sitting here. We are trying to learn about something in the Ramayana. So, Ramo Vigrahavan Dharmaha. So he is the human manifestation of Dharma. When he is the personality of Rama, Dharma, Ramayana, Ayana means Marga, path, way. Rama's Ayana is Dharma's Ayana. So that is how we have to understand. So what Ramayana says is how to behave, how to do your duties. That Ramayana says. There begins the story of Rama. And after that, about Ravana also, we have to understand. If Rama is Dharma, who is Ravana? Ravana is the desire in us. Ravanu Vigrahavan Kamaha. It is not directly told, but in a shloka, I will explain it very soon, how Ramayana came into existence, that I will tell you. And in that story, we come across Ravana's personality as the personality of kama or desire. We have number of desires in us. While we go on the road, we see a beautiful car. Let us purchase this car. That is a desire. And we have seen a latest AC. On seeing that, let us purchase that AC. We have seen a mobile phone, the very beautiful mobile phone. On seeing it, let us purchase that mobile phone. Like that. And we have seen a sweet. Let us purchase and eat. So like this, is there any end for desires? No end. Unending desires are there. Samudro vai kamaha yatha samudrasya naantosti tatha kamasya. It is an instruction from our Subhashitas. Samudro vai kamaha. So the desire is just like an ocean. Do we have end for the ocean? There is no end at all. As there is no end at all for the ocean, for our desires also, there is no end. But we must be careful about this desire. Why? Sometimes it will allow us sleep, it dominates, and when we are not aware of our strength and other things, we are not alert, when we are not alert, the kama or desire will dominate us and it leads to committing some sins, committing some evil deeds. Because of that, we will be an object of the criticism of all, attack of all, and censor of all. Like this, there can be many kinds of effects, bad effects, if we allow the desire to dominate us. That's why what Ramayana teaches us is control the desire. Then that will help you to do your duty well. And when you perfectly perform your duties, you will receive a great name as Rama does. This is the instruction from Ramayana, what we have to take. See how greatly Rama lived. In the Ramayana, we have almost seven khandas. Balakanda, Ayodhya Kanda, Aranya Kanda, Kishkindha Kanda, Sundara Kanda, Yudha Kanda, and Uttara Kanda. Let us take the story of each of this Balakanda, from Balakanda to the Ayodhya Kanda. So Rama, let us take the story of Rama. In the Balakanda, he ruled for 60,000 years. And after ruling for 60,000 years, he had no children. Suddenly, he got realization when he looked into the mirror that he got some gray hair. Till that time, he didn't see. Oh, I got gray hair, but I couldn't get children. What should I do? He performed Putrakameshti as a part of Ashwamedha Yaga with the help of his son-in-law. Rama has a sister. What's the name of Rama's sister?
Shanta Devi.
Excellent. So Shanta Devi is the sister of Rama. And who was the husband of Shanta Devi?
Rishyasringa.
Very nice. Rishyasringa. So that Rishyasringa was the chief priest who helped Dasaratha to perform this Ashwamedha and Putraka Vesti. So as a result, great the Yajnapurusha came and he offered payasa. That payasa anna was distributed to the three wives of Dasaratha, and they consumed it. And as a result, by the grace of the gods, she got four children: Rama, Lakshmana, Bharata, and Shatrughna. Actually, the order is Rama, Bharata, Lakshmana, and Shatrughna. Lakshmana and Shatrughna were the twins, and they were the sons of Sumitra. And this Kaikeyi has Bharata, and Rama was the son of Kaushalya. These were the four children. And when he was growing, actually in his early years, where did he stay? In the ashram of Vasishta for learning all shastras. It was in forest. That is one thing. And after that, just he reached back his kingdom, he was with his father, Vishwamitra came there. Give me your son. He has to protect my yajna. He took him away. There in the forest again, he had to stay. After that, he wandered in the forest. So forest environment is very much known to Rama, right from his childhood. So after that, in the process of protecting the yajna, he killed Maricha and he killed Subahu, and Maricha was driven away to a distant place, and the Stataka also was killed, and all the demons who caused disturbance to this yajna were killed. And before killing all this, Vishwamitra imparted him the secrets of many, many astras, rare astras. That happened. After that, they reached the Mithila. There, Shivadhanus was there. Actually, the breaking Shivadhanus itself is a very wonderful incident about which we can learn a lot. So, 5,000 Divyalohas were used in preparing that Shivadhanu according to our Ramayana. So, just he simply broke that Shivadhanu, and as a result, Sita became his wife. After that, he came back to Ayodhya. They stayed there for some time. And those were the only happy days in the life of Rama. After that, he had to, at the time of incarnation of Rama, that is coronation of Rama, that is Pattabhisheka, when he had to be made the king of Ayodhya, he was asked to, not even asked, actually Kaika asked Dasharatha, he heard it, and just as a son, it is my duty to follow my father, Chitata, and he took leave of all the people and he went to forest. So when he was going along with him, Sita went, and following these two, Lakshmana also went. Each of the characters, Bharata, Lakshmana, Sugriva, Hanuman, Vali, everyone has an ideal teaching for all of us. That is Ramayana, not merely the leader or the hero of the play or hero of the story. Everyone has something to say to us all. That is the greatness of Ramayana. So he went to the forest. Here he tried to understand the environment of the forest. He tried to understand the hearts of all the people. That is why we cannot see any corner of the country where we do not have the temple of Rama. So Rama's temple can be seen even in the corner most place of the forest also. But it is not like with any other god. In such a way, he merged with all the foresters and others. And there he didn't waste his time. He visited the ashrams of all the great sages. He learned from them many dharma sukshmas. That was how he spent his time. We also should try to spend our time by approaching great people wherever we go. That is a lesson for us. After that, he showed the same spirit of love towards birds also, Jatayu and others. He stayed for a long time in Panchavati. Just in the last year, Sita was abducted out of the 14 years. So this here we have in the Panchavati, while Jatayu comes, and wonderful instance is there about Jatayu. Wonderful example for biodiversity concept. In the time of Valmiki can be attained from the history of Jatayu. So Jatayu was protecting Sita in the absence of Rama and Lakshmana, and Ravana came, abducted her, and after that Rama took the help of Sugriva, and then Hanuman, the minister of Sugriva, was sent towards Lanka, and he took a wonderful leap in the Sundarakanda. There was a description and he having taken a great leap, he reached Lanka. He collected all the whereabouts of Ravana. He came back. He informed Rama, and there was a fight between Rama and Ravana. And during that time, a bridge was constructed there over the ocean. That was a great thing again. Over that bridge, all those people very comfortably walked, reached Lanka, and there was a tumultuous war between this Ravana and Rama. And Ravana was killed by Rama effortlessly. After that, Sita came, and after accepting Sita, his Pattabhisheka was over. Up to this, we have the Ayodhya Kanda, the Yuddha Kanda's ending. After that, what had happened, that can be continued in our tomorrow's this sitting. So up to this, we have to know. So when even Vyasa got inspired from Rama. Patha Ramayanam Vyasa Kavyabijam Sanatanam Yatra Rama Charitam Syat Taraham Tatra Shaktiman. Lord Vishnu inspired Vyasa to read Ramayana for the sake of getting energy to write Ashtadasa Puranas, Mahabharata and other texts. So that is the greatness of Rama, Ramacharita. Ramacharita inspired not only the people of Kali Yuga, it inspired the people of Dwapara Yuga also. It inspired the people of his own times. So it inspired the people of his own family. Everyone got inspired. Even Shatrus, on seeing Rama's appearance, they got infatuation. So such a great personality. Pumsam Mohana Rupaya, that is Rama's formation, and we'll be learning about the rest of the things about Ramayana in our tomorrow's class. It's a great opportunity given to me through the organizers of this Dharma Mola. I sincerely express my thanks to all, particularly to Kumbhal Sharmagaru, and also I offer my salutations to Vijayendra Saraswati Swamigaru, and my pranams to all elders here, and thanks to all, and blessings to all the children who have attended this session.
Thank you, sir. You excellent.